verdade. Ok, we need to let Oh, we close stuff to this. Okay, so I didn't get to check this stuff to the right there. So it's like that is something to do. Service memo. The old canal is finally clean and locks 4 to 7 have been serviced. All my time as a water surveyor, I've never seen the water level this low, but at least I was able to give the canal a good clean. Let's just say it was about time. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Never been this filthy in my entire life. Up the clock for this sleep. Until next time, eat up. So that was the tool shop. I created all kind of things. Creatures up in the bad creatures that they talk about. Or if it's just a culture. Lisa, thank you for your support. Thanks to you, we can continue to work to protect free humps in Syria. Lawrence. Without your help, we would never have been able to renovate our shelter. I'm also happy to announce that the time has come. We have begun releasing some of our rescued Sorans back into the wild. This time we are working with Spockishroom growers to preserve shaded areas vital to Sorans. Confident that, that reintroduction them back into their natural habitat will be a success. Still unclear how we're going to help the remaining ones adapt to the life of the Great Plain. Now this first phase is complete, at least the species' survival is assured. Thank you again, Anne. Hey, Mama, somebody asked me to clear out the cellar so they could store the furniture there, and I came across some old clothes that must have belonged to Grandpa. They don't look like anything we wear here anyway. I had to throw them all out. Some sorrows may have made a nest in them and chewed them all up. Wonder what it was like up there, the storm. Did you ever go back? You said it drove Grandpa completely crazy, but I never got the chance to talk to him about it. No, he never talked about anything much. The old man wasn't chatty as the folks. The wind picked up. I don't remember how old I was. I could barely stand on my 2 feet. That was a long time ago. When a storm like that came along, I wasn't allowed to go outside. I wasn't allowed to do much, come to think of it. Those were different times, eh? Then everything stopped, that part you know. But up there, oh, the raging storm stuck. The wind howled and howled. It was enough to drive you mad. Couldn't live up there anymore, you see. So we came down here. And now there's talk of climbing down again. Will it ever end? Okay. Need to get to that side. Nada. Put in a Okay, so let's see. And here we go. What the heck are we supposed to do here then? Because on that side, it's falling apart anyway, so I can't go there. Because I can't get through there. It's like up is the way to go, but that doesn't seem feasible either. Going over to that side ain't doing us any good. Seems like there's something supposed to be here. That one is gonna open or something. Because climbing up there ain't gonna do me any good. Thank you. grab hold of. So that side doesn't do us any good either. So, to go this way. The heck? I'm holding both arms. Like I asked a bait going into that room. It was full of false hopes. Excuse me, game, what the heck was that? Yeah, I don't understand why that one went that way. Thank you. Logbook 13 octaves and one third after the new sun. We dug for a while at the home of an old local farmer, Gal. For him, always having a wall within reach and a roof over your head is comforting. A feeling of safety you don't get in the open air. He made me laugh. This guy? No, thank you. I saw it once and he made me dizzy. Gal seems to be all alone in the world, but he can't bring himself to leave the tower. We don't have to ask twice for him to tell us about the water. He mainly remembers the sound of it made when he was just a tadpole, as he put it, and the silence that followed the drought. He spoke of full canals and waterfalls of mud and pruny skin, and I wasn't the only one listening. In the light of glowing mushrooms, people's faces were exhausted, but their eyes were bright. The entire group hung on to this, onto his every word. We would listen to his stories once we were gone. We ended up staying at the farm, delaying our departure just a little longer. There was no shortage of excuses. Gal's farm needed extra hands. There was a building frame to repair, spare parts to break track down, ropes to replace. It felt good to be working on something concrete rather than wearing myself out on an interminable climb chasing after legends. Probably the same feeling that keeps me carving my little sculptures. When it was time to leave, Mette stayed behind. There was no need to explain, the group understood. All of us were secretly hoping to stay at Gal's farm. Well, I was. But I guess I'm still holding out a glimmer of hope for this expedition. Saying goodbye to Mette was probably the hardest thing I had to do since I started this climb. I don't know if I feel like writing anymore, or have the energy to. Goodbye, maybe, Bianca. Yeah, no, you're still around. How are things out there? Still no rain? I host a group from your part of the tower here. Off chasing clouds or whatever's in them. Had a great time and I got a new housemate out of it too. A youngster who reminds me of you. It'd be nice having two of us to run what's left of the farm. Hey, old man. Great to hear from you. I'm glad to know you're in good company. Cass and I were actually just talking about the odd jobs I used to do. Been a while now since the harvest, hasn't it? When I think back to it now, it seems crazy how many people would come help you pick up the sparkle shrooms. Well, mostly because of the pies you make them for snack time. You know, you never did give me the recipe. Coming. That was a visual bug. No more water, eh? We'll see about that. I'm sure if you dig deep enough, there's water to be found. No one believes me, but I believe in myself, and that's the main thing. Come on, old boy. You're prude and wrong. Worst that can happen is that I'll find treasure. Or a caramel seam. That's some good stuff, caramel. Okay, so... that side on? Everything. People are in 200 jumps or double jumps in the game. Acrobats. This morning I forgot to put lychee in my drink, but drank it anyway, and then cried tears of joy because my toast was so delicious. I'm so wound up, I can't get anything done. I don't know if I should blame the drought, the evacuation that started, or the end of the world. Anyway, I got mushrooms to grow. Okay. To be beads, like a time glass or something. I mean, big roots even. Oh, go for a ride. Echo. Say no to locks. Modern people should be able to flow freely. We can't deny the many for the sake of the few. In the current crisis, it's our duty to stand in solidarity with living things. We confine the water is to confine us all. At regular information sessions at the Market Canteen, the White Water Collective. Community canteen, upcoming activities, permanent team to fight water insecurity, fundraising dinners for the White Water Collective, repair workshop, all items accepted. Note, the canteen will open one prime earlier to reduce overcrowding. Pay what you can to help in the kitchen, arrive early in the sleep. All help welcome. No one comes by anymore. I haven't sold a single flower. Should I switch careers? But I don't know how to do anything besides taking care of plants. I might as well write poetry, right? Or try to, at least. Roses are red, violets are blue. Where, oh, where has everyone gone to? Yeah. Like I said, issue 37, 8 octaves and 2 faves after the use sound. Editorial in this issue, we'll be looking at ammo from the outside of the Waybeak. Waybeaks are the only animals found in the every region of the tower. Every known region, at least. Sometimes they even venture into our tunnels. These medium-sized birds are known for all their white feathers and blue comb. Not uncommon to see the playful birds gliding through the warm grass that rise up the cliffs of the tower. They are also extremely curious, can often be found perched near climbing routes, observing and commenting on what's happening with their fellow birds. Not only are they big social creatures, they are also skilled builders. They work together to build a nest, which have multiple entrances and can house dozens of waybeaks. They are constantly strengthening and expanding the nest and are always on the lookout for twigs. Hence the expression, working like a waybeak. Did you know waybeak's combs open and close depending on their mood? A wide open comb means the waybeak is alert or stressed about something. Someone. But if enough shadow, keep reading for an in-depth look at the lives of these outwardly unassuming yet fascinating birds. Dear editor, I have only read a tutorial and I'm already outraged. It all sounds very nice, but you might want to think twice before publishing such nonsense. Waybeaks are thieves. They're always stealing my wood to build a nest. I'm unscribing. Signed, a disgruntled citizen. Okay, buddy. Thank you. to be able to. Come now, dear friend, enough moping around. The situation isn't as hopeless as that. I'm quite certain the water supply is being managed by some very competent people. I've no doubt that they have a clear plan to get us out of this mess. Believe me, there's no cause for concern. Good coming over for tea? We have filled the basin. Nothing like a bit of swimming to chase away the blues. Blues way soos. Grab them. Mm-hmm. What the heck was that bullshit? Shuffle. That's a long way then. Temple. Especially if the water is reached all the way up here at some point. Thank you. that one went all that way down. Wasn't really jumping all the way to there though. Just wanted to get to... in case. Back out, tummy in. Up there. Pass for the water then. Thank you. Every day I have to go to the market. The watering net is acting up again. Things are starting to get complicated. Really thought that by holding back the water, but there's nothing to be done. The basins are empty. I think it's time for a more radical change. What would happen if we would let the water flow freely from the start? I'm boring you with my musings, but sometimes I get the feeling we have made a big mistake. There's a pier collapsing in the Boatman's district. Do you think you could take care of it? Hey Joe, things are non-stop at the moment and I have to go fishing for a new team to shore it up. Isa's already over at the Two Pillars site. As for other stuff, I don't know what to say. What's done is done. Alright, I'll pick up the supplies I need and then I'm off to the Boatman's district. Hey big guy, I hope you're well. You know, I still don't like the thought of you perched above that basin. It's too big. We just aren't made for the open air. We're better off in our tunnels where it's cozier. You might have already heard, but the Ends barge is finally back on dry land. They can't drive it anymore, they say. But you should see them now. They have never been so busy. They're working at a sour rescue center or some such thing, if you can believe it. Who would want to save sours? Seriously. They always look so disgruntled, like they are judging us, but things haven't been easy for Anne. They seem happy again. That's what matters. Your father played a song for you. It was beautiful. May the currents be kind to you, wherever they are. Walking. We are the water surveyors. In the dark tunnels we guide, clean, navigate rivers and streams. For the water called forth in the day and the sky can fill, nourish, cherish all living things. I guess we're supposed to go all the way down there. Oh, come on. Don't know why you can't just get that when you... Like, right there. Another seashell. This one. Just reading a book with a nice view, with a cup of tea, I guess. Not bad. I often wonder what would have happened if the rain had returned. Would we still have met? Or would we have led parallel lives elsewhere, each of us unaware of the other's existence? This month of seeing the great basin dry up more with each sleep fills me with despair. I can't help but be happy by your side. Up we go. It's like we're getting closer to the top. Hmm. Want to blow the E-shell into the weapons. Flying!